It's a balanced budget that we're presenting you. There's no mill levy increase. We have a 4% wage increase that's included in this budget. No additional employees. We continue the process of paying cash for large projects. Our reserve funds are maintained and are healthy. And then this, we have a fully funded street program. In the general fund, our projected revenue is around $12 million. We do have sales tax coming in. We project that to be flat for the coming year. So our revenue is going to stay right about where it was in 2017 or where we expect it to be in 2017. We did decrease expenditures by over $200,000. And you'll notice we did that with no reduction in services. And we also have a 4% wage increase included. So I think that's pretty impressive that we were able to cut by $200,000 and still include those things. We have transfers of $500,000 to the Special Highway Fund. That's for the street maintenance program, and that was something that we started a few years ago, and we continue that for 2018. And then we have a transfer of $800,000 to the Commission Capital Reserve, and those are the funds that we use for the large capital projects. And that is in line with what we plan to transfer in 2017 as well. The mill levy, we projected to remain stable at 25 mills. And that's it's been at or below 25 for 11 of the last 12 years, so that's something we're pretty proud of. We're the sixth lowest levy in Kansas, and we're also the lowest levy outside of Johnson County, so that's something that we should be proud of, being able to keep our levies low. The monthly tax liability for the citizens for the median home value in the city of Hays, so that's $37.85. And that provides all the services that in conjunction with sales tax, provides all the services that we have here in Hays. And I did this calculation with a couple of other cities, just so you can see how we compare. Garden City is about $10 more than this. Saline is about $8 more. Great Bend is about $40 more. And some of the smaller communities around get even higher than that. If you look at Ellis and Victoria, Plainville, those are over $100. So our taxes, even though our assessed valuation is a little bit higher, maybe people think that's too high, we still have a low property tax. And actually, if you look at this, that $37, the city's portion of that is actually only $27. If you back out the library, it's only $27 for all the services that we provide.